Hello, my name is Tom Mercer, and I'm running for the Chesapeake Public School Board. I thank you for taking the time to find out a little bit more about me. Let me say that on May the 1st, there will be an election, and I'll be one of the candidates for Chesapeake Public Schools. You'll have an opportunity to fill 4 seats on the Chesapeake Public School Board, and I hope that you'll give me one of your votes on May 1st, 2012. I think that we can be proud of our Chesapeake Public Schools, and I've been a part of that for over a decade. Chesapeake has the lowest dropout rate in our region. It has the highest on-time graduation rate in Southampton Roads, and currently Chesapeake is the only public school system that has 100% accredited schools on the standards of learning. That's quite an accomplishment. It's one that we can be proud of. I learned long ago that when you see a turtle on the fence post, you know one thing, it didn't get there by itself. And I didn't do all of those accomplishments myself. I've been part of a team of administrators and teachers and bus drivers and cafeteria workers and custodians and teachers' aides and office personnel and central office personnel and all the support staff of Chesapeake Public Schools and a school board that has taken the time to invest in the most precious gift that we have in our community, and that is the next generation, our students. And we've done that, and it has borne great benefits. And I want to continue, especially during these tough economic times, to be able to get the best results with limited funds for our children, so that every child, as we like to say now on the Chesapeake School Board, has the potential of becoming that masterpiece that we all know that they can be if they're given the right resources, if they're given the right teachers and support staff that care about that child so that they can accomplish everything possible. In order to do that, especially during these times, we're going to need to make sure that we continue to protect our children, that we make sure that we have safe environments for them to be able to learn in. It's one of the reasons that while other school systems thought that it might be a costly project, we decided that we were going to fingerprint people as they came into our schools. To make sure that our schools had another element of safety, we design our schools today so that they are protected as much as possible from anything coming in and harming children. And while there's no absolute guarantee, you have it as a pledge from me that as long as I'm on the Chesapeake Public Schools, we're going to do everything to make that learning environment as safe as possible. We also, in these times, have had to enlarge class sizes, but we've done it only as a last resort. We have made sure that we have tried to keep what cuts we've had to make to our school budget as far away from students as possible. Also, technology. Technology continues to change. 4 years ago, I wouldn't have even thought of communicating to you right now in the way in which I'm communicating. But that's how fast things are moving in the world in which we live. And so we need to be very smart in the technology that we buy for our public schools, but we need to buy the right equipment to prepare our students for the generation that lies ahead. It's one of the reasons that I'm proposing an initiative that every child in Chesapeake Public Schools that is going for an advanced diploma has to take an online course before he or she graduates. Most children that are getting our advanced degrees are going on to college, and they are going to, when they go to those colleges, take so many courses that are online. In fact, one of the questions many colleges are now asking is, did you take any online courses while you were in school? And we need to prepare while also doing the traditional methods of education. We need to prepare children for the future as well. We also need to have a commitment to fiscal responsibility. And your school system has done that, and I've been a part of working with the administrators and my fellow school board members to be as fiscally responsible as possible. I don't have to tell you, these have been tough times, and since 2008, the last 4 years, we are working with $58 million less than we were working at in 2008. We've had to cut some programs that just have made me very, very sad. We've had to cut through attrition, and we've only done it through attrition, some staff members and some staff positions that we certainly hated to see go. But we've always had a guiding principle that we would teach children the things that were necessary, and as much as possible, we would keep those cuts out of the daily classroom experience. And I pledge that in the future, if you will allow me to continue on the Chesapeake Public School Board, that I'll do those same guiding principles in the next 4 years of my term.